естественно, уже в феврале, когда была, ну, как бы победа народа, да, когда импичмент произошел, все понимали, что самая главная работа впереди по изменению страны, очищению страны от коррупции, да, от того, за что боролись, в общем-то, да, против чего боролись. И сейчас это болезненный процесс, он еще долго будет продолжаться, да, страна все-таки. И очень многие сейчас говорят о том, что все, ну, Майдан, да, и события зимы показали, что все реально просто никто не хотел. Да, и если мы можем сами себя обеспечить, сами себя содержать, покрыть расходы на врачей, да, на и так далее, то и государство может. Значит, государству мешало что-то другое, да, нежелание содержать страну в порядке. Как бы. И, конечно, очень, ну, мои прогнозы сейчас, они мне говорят о том, что очень вырастет ресурс действительно самосознания. Да, он уже очень вырос, и его можно использовать дальше. И это моя мечта, как бы, чтобы его вот не потерять. Да? То есть сейчас уже очень вырос этот ресурс.
Now we try to transform our work of initiative to a new threats which we faced, because we faced the military occupation of Crimea and active involvement Russia in creating, assisting aggressive military separatist groups in the east and south of Ukraine. And unfortunately, lawyer can't do nothing in such conditions because this aggressive group take people like a hostage, beaten people severely, even killed, for example, two weeks ago they captured, severely tortured and killed the friends of my family who from Gorlovka. It's a local deputy, and he was killed only because he tried to stand the national flag on the building where it was thrown away. So in such condition, no lawyers can help. What we do now, we work in format of human rights mobile group who go to Crimea, to south, to east, go to each small towns, and they have several tasks. First, they monitor human rights violation and document it, have photo, video, testimonies, etc. Second, if they can, they interference in the situation, so they help people to transmit in from one region to another quickly. If they see that people need money, we ask partners initiatives to help them with treatment or something like this. So we try to help the people. Second, their task is that they provide a truthful information what happens, and third, they organize a regional network, because we, especially in Crimea, where the majority of human rights activists and human rights defenders had to leave peninsula, we need to establish a new civil institutes, organizations, activists, and we try to get known, to get acquaintance with new people.
Okay, we won. Yes. Like active Maidan finished at some point, and as No Borders project works with refugees, asylum seekers, we understood that it will be a problem in Crimea, and especially after that referendum on 16th of March, and we understood that people will need help. So, and it was again, like, we decided that we can start some kind of hotline. The first point, it was like hotline, just for those people who were in this strange situation and they didn't know what to do, how to behave, where to move, or needed just advice. So we started this as the hotline. We gathered all the information about those problems, and we decided to make these online forums for those people who were willing to accommodate people from Crimea or other regions.
At the moment, before these events in Odessa, we had in our list 133 cases that are confirmed their connection with Maidan events or different events in other regions of Ukraine, like Kharkiv, like Khmelnytsky, and other like Crimea, because we think that all these events are interconnected, because if there is no Maidan, there will be no Russian invasion to Crimea and to eastern and southern part of Ukraine. So from that moment we work and we collect all the information.
Ukraine is quite a young country and young nation, and lots of people think that if you are on Maidan, for example, it's enough. It's like a proofment that you are a citizen, that you are doing everything like a real Ukrainian and real like real citizen. But this was the moment when I felt that it's not enough, that being a citizen, it's, and for many people, it's not only like to do the protest, to express your opinion, but is some actions. These are some actions like being to monitor, for example, the electoral process, to participate in some human rights initiatives, to like to do more, some constructive actions which can like establish new practices in society. And you can see clearly that after appearing Euromaidan SOS initiative, we had numerous very similar things, like Odessa SOS. Now after the crackdown of Tituska's on Odessa citizens, we have Donbass SOS. It's these initiatives, they do very similar things as we do, and like it was a kind of model for others, and it showed that there's a request in society for this very constructive reaction, not destructive, when everybody's like willing to do to crash something, but very constructive. And that's what makes me very optimistic.